Okay, now on the screen is the first slide. Again, this is our first virtual orientation. This is at the same time our first online class, but this is just a trial class. Okay, the official start of the school year 2020-2021 will be on October 5. But today is just September 30, so we are calling this as a mock class or a trial class only. This is just to check or to assess kung kaya sa aton section ang isa sa mga options sa new distance learning, and that is online class. Okay, so let's start now. Okay, so the next slide will show the netiquette or the online rules. And since this is a new setup, I'm going to mention some of the rules that we have to consider while taking this trial class or virtual meeting. So first rule is, para maiwasan ang disorganized na presentation, so mute yourself when you're not talking. Okay, so since I am the administrator of this Google Meet, I can actually mute you when you are talking. However, kay para hindi ko magsagi-click dira sang mute, make sure lang na naka-mute ang inyong button, kay batiyon niya na sa tanan if naka-unmute ka mo. Okay, just like here, click please mute your... Kung mag-leave ka mo sa group, automatically pagbalik ninyo, nag-unmute ka mo sina. So make sure nga i-mute niyo before ka mo mag-answer sang call-out. Okay, next is to turn on your video always. Again, but this is not really a requirement since not all may aras ng stable internet connection, and para mas mabatian, importante ang audio more than the video. So you can just turn your video off or your camera off while the class is ongoing or while the presentation is ongoing. Okay, one moment, excuse me, I have to reply with this important message now. Okay, let's have the next rule. Don't do other private things while on a meeting. This one, kay I am recording this call. Pag later on, i-upload niya siya sa atong Facebook page maybe or sa YouTube or any other platform. Kagbasi, may ginubra ko muna nga hindi pwede sa public. So avoid. Make sure na what you're doing is for the public to see. So basi, may ibang ka muna ang ginubra, set aside lang na, and ano lang, focus lang na on this online class or this virtual conference. Another thing is, if you can find a quiet space, kay later on, I will be asking you to say something. And para at least hindi man distracting ang gahod, make sure na you are in a quiet place. Next, if you want to raise a concern, type your concern in the chat section. Especially if, kaya kuya, gahambal lang ko din, hindi ko actually mabalaan kung klaro or hindi, naku, or basi choppy ng connection, or basi wala naging ko connection at all. So please, type sa chat box, kaya open akong chat box diriya ha, diri sa Google Meet mismo. May ara dira sang chat option. Kung hindi nakubatian, type lang dira. Or hindi klaro akong ginambal, pwede ka muka on sang microphone or pwede nyo ma-chat sa chat box para at least mabalaan da. Okay, next, number 6. If you want to speak, ask first in order to be recognized. Okay, so pwede man di maging strict ng rule kung gusto mo lang magambal, yeah, just mention your name lang or excuse me sir para at least i-address ko na imo name para kahambal ka, para hindi magdululungan, para hindi masabad ang aton nga conference. Kay budlay ni kay online, so dapat one speaker at a time lang. Number 7. Be respectful. I just added this one, okay, para at least, again, okay, this is recorded. Hindi naman gusto mag-viral in a negative way. tamo na mga videos nga nag-come out nga medyo nag-viral pero yung negative nga aspect, so we are avoiding that. So as much as possible, be respectful, especially if others are speaking or may concern. Kung may gusto pa i-comment, be respectful lang. Again, we are not really in a classroom, kay we are in a new setup, so pwede ni siya gidya ma-access sa ibang nga tao later on. So be mindful of your actions. This one, please take down notes. Kay again, this is already an orientation para at least kung may mga important details ako nga i-mention or information nga i-mention, at least you have notes on that. But another option is for you to take screenshots if you're using your cell phone, or take pictures. Okay? Better if may notes, may screenshot, may pictures, kid, para dumafeel nyo liwat ang pagiging estudyante. Kay again, this is new to everybody, and at least dumafeel nyo nga para kamulot sa spilahan, di magsulat-sulat, mga kamudera, or pangita kamuda sa notebook, and other things, or another means na ma-record or masulat ninyo atong discussion. Number 9, be active and interactive. So later on again, you will have your time to interact. So I am requesting all of you to participate. So be active and interactive. And finally, stay focused. Again, this is just for 1 hour. Siguro, I don't know lang, hopefully ka mag-exceed. Pero kung mag-exceed, okay lang man. Hopefully kaya isang connection. Pero mga 20 slides man lang di akong game prepare. So hopefully matapos na tanan by the end of 1 hour. Okay, now we will be having the checking of attendance. So lainis siyang setup. Okay, this is the set. This will be our checking of attendance. Okay, the next slide, I have here your class list, and so far the names here are covered. And as I mentioned your name, Angel, please mute na your audio. Again, as I show your name, please say present, meaning you have to turn on your audio or unmute your audio, and then say present. Okay, let's start with the first name, Abad Christian Abi. So he already informed me that he can't join the virtual meeting, so I'll mark him not present lang. So not present si Abi. Okay, next, David John Balion. I don't think he is present. I don't see his name as well, Dere. Next name, Jumel Batan. Please say present. Jumel, I can see you are here, but I would like to hear kung ari ka gid man. Please say present lang if you're here.
Present, sir. Present.
Thank you, Jumel. Next, John Russell Batuon.
Present, sir.
Okay, thank you. Next, Narvin. Okay, Narvin, I can see you are here, but let me hear you. Narvin. Medyo hinagoy yung connection. Anyway, let's not check later. Cyril messaged me nga hindi man siya maka-attend sa online meeting. Donnie?
Present, sir.
Okay, thank you, Donnie. Narvin, kung okay na yung audio, just ano lang, say your name para ma-present pa kali. Joshua?
Present, sir.
Okay, noted. Facilito.
Present, sir.
Okay, noted. Joseph. Joseph, medyo nag-disconnect siya kagina.
Present, sir.
Okay. Thank you, Joseph. Vaughn, Brian.
Present, sir.
Thank you. For those who have already said present, please also double check the spelling of your name. Okay, kasi pala may sala ang spelling or sala ang middle initial. It is not the time for you to correct me. Okay, again, this is very, very important. Kaya muna niya ang name na ma-appear sa inyong diploma, sa inyong cards, sa inyong transcript, sa inyong, yes, records. So kung sala ang spelling, timubudlayan ka muna later on. Kaya so far, for those who have been asked already to say present, kung may sala, ano lang, just turn your audio. Turn your audio on. Okay, next, Edmark. You see here, Orocio. I don't think it's present. So wala sa dito. Okay. Arvin, are you around? No answer. Christian, pasig na. Narvin, ikaw to, Narvin. May nagarong kay Narvin connection. Anyway, again, present. Ano ka din, Narvin? Christian, pasig na. Ari siya din. Nawala, no? Wala siya. Janus, nag-try siya kagina. Ba't mong arik siya sa buong? Are you still here?
Present, sir.
Sino ni Janus? Ah, okay, Ari.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Noted. Cliff? If where's Cliff? Okay, Cliff. Please check ara pa ang presentation. Nakikita niyo pa ang PowerPoint?
Hindi na, sir.
Hindi na, sir.
Ganyan, okay. Dala lang.
Wala pa man ang PowerPoint.
Hindi na, sir.
Kita. Hindi na, sir.
Kita, sir.
Kita,
gyapon,
sir.
Why nagana kon? Why gagana ang microphone sa kon earphones? Muna na bakal ko.
Yes, I can hear you, Cliff. Ikaw na, Cliff.
Oh, sir.
Okay. Hindi ka po, kita na ang PowerPoint.
Kita on, kita, sir.
Kita on na, sir.
Kita, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, so let's have the next name. Sorry, hindi na ta. After na ni Cliff. Angel, May, Alba?
Present, sir.
Okay. Blossom, Aspera. Wala si Blossom. Mia, Mika?
Present, sir.
Okay. Chami. Chami, are you there? Ari siya, pero may problema lang sa audio. Balikan na lang. Kayla?
Present, sir.
Okay. Crisel?
Present, sir.
And out there. Carissa? Ay, si Carissa?
Present, sir.
Okay. Jemima? time, ha? Okay. Hindi ko lang kung pati ano yung audio, pero you're present here. Justin?
Present, sir.
Okay. Noted. Christine May?
Present, sir.
Okay. Shella?
Present, sir.
Okay. Genevieve?
Present, sir.
Okay, good. Julian?
Present, sir.
Okay, very good. Justin Romualdo?
Present, sir.
Thank you. Debbie Rose? Are you there, Bibi Rose? Are you Bibi Rose? Tungilon? Wala siya. Si Jeremy?
Hindi, stable niya ako, sir.
Ah, okay, okay. Okay, so si Jeremy nag-message to sa akin. Okay, so at least majority is present. So hopefully we can have our virtual class later on. This one, this is another important information. Okay, aside from our group chat, I'm also going to inform you of some of the things or update you on of some of the things about the school through SMS or the text. So I don't know if you were able to receive my text message last night and update your info. I am now showing here on the screen your contact information. Okay, please check your number, and if your contact number here is not anymore updated, kung hindi lang updated, amo lang na siya ang mahambal para makorrect ko ang iyang contact number. Deverose, sorry, person. Okay, kitaon, tanan inyong contact info and tama inyong contact info, please. Somebody confirm kung kitaon, kag kung tama. Ah, para dasigta, please, ano na lang, sa chat lang, para nito mag-on audio, please type correct if tama ang imo na contact number. Avon, please type your number, Avon. Aside from Von, who else so far do correct man tanan? I do not have the contact information of David Jan Balion, si Ma'am Elde na lang siniguro ako may contact. But the rest, I hope this number is still active. Joseph, please just type your new number. 1959. Who else? It's only Vaughn so far and Joseph. Okay, if you have corrections with your contact info, you may just again type in the chat box para ma-inform ako sa inyong bagong contact number. Again, this is very important. Kay dili ko tanan i-announce ang mga important ng mga announcement from the school aside sa group chat. I-text again ka mo immediately para at least you are very much informed of the updates. Okay, so again, kung may problema, yung number, just ano lang, type your number in the chat box. Okay, let's now have the next slide. This one now is just a short discussion. Kay Damo, it actually naka question kung ano gidya ang atong setup comes October 5, which is the official start of the school year 2020-2021. Okay, so since this is a new setup, this is a new situation to all of us, so the Department of Education has come up with also a new solution to our problem. Okay, and Cliff, I think need mo lang i... Okay. Sige, dala.
Ipin ninyo ang kay Sir na...
Duwa dabi ako na account. Ang duwa, ang isa binafor chat na siya kay cellphone. Ako nagamit sa isa. Ang isa laptop. So, ang laptop, dira ang may presentation. Okay, dali lang. Anyway, sa akong phone, di mo nabi kita. Okay, stop ko dan na yung presentation. And then, start to load. Kaya again, stop ko na ang presentation so hindi nyo makita. But this time, I'll again present using my entire screen. Okay, what about this time?
Kita na, sir.
Okay, good.
Kita na, sir.
Okay, very good.
Okay na, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so I hope, please, kung hindi ka makita ang presentation, siguro sa connection lang. Pero kung majority hindi makakita, confirm nyo lang sa chat para at least ma-adjust na kung dito. Importante na siya ito nga i-discuss sa next na slide. Okay, again, the next slides will help you understand kung ano gidya ang aton gamiton nga setup sa aton new school year. Okay, so LDM, by the way, stands for Learning Delivery Modalities. Okay, we have different types of learning delivery modalities depende kung ano ang gamiton sa section or sa eskwelahan. Okay, that's why if you can remember, nagpamangkot ako sa mga questions about kung kaya nyo mag-install Google Meet or kung hard copy or soft copy ang kailangan, itungod lain, depende ya sa section. Okay? So, i-discuss ko na ito na para mas maintindihan ganyan nyo. Okay, so again, these are the four learning delivery modalities. First is the face-to-face. Okay, I'm just looking at my phone. Do wala siya nag... Okay, ayan na. Okay, so again, the first learning delivery modality is face-to-face, and according sa announcements ng government, there will be no face-to-face unless may vaccine. That is for everybody, all schools in the Philippines, no face-to-face unless may vaccine. That's the first. Amo na siya ang last year kang ginagamit. So madula na siya. Okay, so ang option next is to have the distance learning. And what is this distance learning? Of course, no need for you to be in school, and there must be a connection between the teacher and the student. It may be online or through mobile phone, through laptop with internet connection. That's distance learning. If it is a combination, then it is called blended learning. Okay. However, sa blended learning, dapat may face-to-face. So, upang ang term lang yung naging gamit is blended learning, therefore, may present gidira nga face-to-face. Ang blended learning is a combination of the four. Example, maghambal ka blended, face-to-face plus distance, that is blended. Blended also is face-to-face plus homeschooling. Or face-to-face plus distance plus homeschooling is equal to blended learning. So, basically, blended learning means face-to-face plus another learning delivery modality. Okay? Blended learning na siya. So, wrong ang term actually na ang ginagamit is blended learning kay wala tayo sang face-to-face. So, kung wrong ang blended learning, ano ya ang correct na term? So, amun niya ang gusto kong i-correct. Kaya mga estudyante sometimes, even teachers, gambal sila nga a blended learning among nagamiton, which in fact is wrong. Kaya dapat may face-to-face ya sa blended learning. So what is the correct term there? Okay, so the correct term is these options now. The first is modular distance learning. What will happen to us, Arisha, is only distance learning. Wala face-to-face, wala blended learning, wala man tas ang homeschooling, kaya usually ang homeschooling, more sa private ni siya, wala ga-allow ang DepEd sa homeschooling. So distance learning lang gid matabo. Pero ano gid yung specific sa distance learning? So the next slides will show you the 5 distance learning modalities. So the first is modular distance learning. Amo ni sa siguro ang nababatian nyo per me, ang modular ilang distance learning. So kung modular distance learning lang, amo lang ni ang mga kailangan sa teacher and also the students. Ang module or the SLM, ang correct term yun sa module is actually SLM. Short that for self-learning material. So amo na siya ang ginaprint namun mga teachers para ihatag sa estudyante. However, take note na may duwa ka form ang SLM. It could be printed or digital. Siyempre, mga maka-print, ang mugi na siya ma-print sa printer. Ang digital, ara lang siya as a soft copy. So later on, i-explain ko na further kung ano ginang option na para sa inyo. Also, aside sa modules or SLM, pwede man ang libro, kung may libro ang amun na ang subject, or activity sheets. So these are the resources needed for modular distance learning. Kung online, okay, diri na yan nagasulod ang cellphone, ang laptop, tablets, and etc. And of course, internet connection. Okay, this is the way for the teachers to communicate with the students through the use of these technologies also connected sa internet. Ang ibang pagid nga pwede makuhaan sa mga resources, ang DepEd Commons, this is for the teachers lang. And also the LR portal. So never mind ang DepEd Commons and LR portal kay mas concerned in as teachers. This one. Okay? Amo ni tanin man nami kung may ara lang sang channel na accessible para sa majority na communities, the TVBI or the TV based instruction. So ang DepEd makam up sila sang channel, ang tawag is DepEd TV ag dira i-present ang mga SLMs in a form of TV-based instruction. So may role-playing, may do drama, may experimentation na sa TV i-present. Naka-oras na siya. Example, by 8:30, ang grade 1 na science ang munang i-discuss. Pag 9:30, sa the whole week na siya, bilog na, asa na sa senior high school. Manami siya taling idea, galing kaya the problem is, ang connection kay especially mag-close ng ABS-CBN. So, ang GMA is not also accessible man to everybody. Duha man lang yung major networks tani na pwede gid maka-present sini sa TVBI na ma-cover sa other or makuhaan sa mga communities. So, mabudlay na ni siya subong option. Ang radio-based instruction is of course kung sa radyo lang. And ang last na option, or na si David. Okay. Welcome, David. I hope makalagas ka sa discussion. Ang last na option is the blended distance learning. Okay? Maka-blended, again, combination sa PTV. Yes, tama sa dito. Sa PTV na siya, galing kay again, hindi tanan maka-access ang PTV. Kailangan mo sa cable para maka-access ka sa PTV. Amuni siya ang nagiging problema. Unlike ya kung free network siya, bala, pero sa EBS kasi sa GMA, na may antenna ka lang, makuha mo na dayon ang signal. So para tanan, hindi yan makatanaw. So mo na sa tani. Pero ang isa po sa mga options, TV siya, pero i-stream siya through Facebook, through YouTube, pero doon hindi na siya gapon. Doon social media na siya ng formal instruction, pero actually, supposedly for TV na siya. Yes, sa PTV, government-owned din na ang PTV. Okay? Going back again, ang blended distance learning, kung gina-combine mo to ang gin-mention, ang unang gin-mention, so kung modular plus online, modular and TV or radio, online, TV and radio, kung i-combine mo na, blended distance learning. Okay? So, nagpa-survey si Sir Charlie, kag nag-ask, based man sa inyong answers, sa out of, I think, pila ka section sa Jose Diva, dua lang gid ang blended distance learning. Ang grade 11 STEM, tag ang grade 12 STEM aton nga section. So kitungod nga gin-combine naton ang modular kagang online distance so blended distance learning na. Okay? So may inclusion ng online distance learning kitungod pareho sini sa ginobrata nag Google Meet kita, gina-text ta kamo, nag-discuss ta. So may online nga involved. Kung modular lang gyud, wala ni sa halo, wala gini halos inisang online. Puro lang tanan sarili lang gid ninyo ya nga pamaagi nga maka-learn kamo through the modules. That's why ani self-learning material. So mas gina-encourage ko gid tani, especially kay STEM kamo ya, nga mag-blended gid kita. Hindi man ni everyday later on i-discuss ko yung schedule. Hindi man na siya actually gid 24 hours or 8 hours kamo nga ma-connect. Hindi man i-present ko later on ang inyong schedule. Pero at least ya may ara sang option nga maka-discuss kita. Pero sini kay ako ya do okay na kita sa blended kay halos tanan man kamo naka-connect. Para at least ang iba nyong subject teachers, especially pag abot sa physics kag chemistry, to kabudlay gina yang may ginabasa ng kamong kagkamuda yung answer do nabudlayan ko mag visualize nga maka-learn kamo. So better okay, sorry, better those. Okay. Better now, better ang audio. Please confirm. Okay nang audio.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay. Lang sir.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, man, sir.
Okay, sige, thank you. Please mute again your audio. Okay, again, sa STEM, ya, gina-encourage ko, Gabe, na mag-blended distance learning kita. Kaya para bulig man actually sa inyo, na hindi lang kamo ang nag-learn on your own, a self-learning material lang inyo ginagamit. At least, ya, kung may pareho sini, kung may mga concepts na gusto nyo i-discuss sa inyo, maubra natin through this medium. Ang mga hindi maka-access, amo naman na siyang another option. Basta maka-connect lang later on, maka-record man ini atong discussion, speaking, wala ko nina record, dili ang another discussion. Wait, let me just check. Ah, okay, naka-record. Good. Sorry. Okay. So again, ang tawag sa aton na method ya is blended distance learning. Again, ang difference ang blended learning sa blended distance learning. So kung mamakot ang inyong parents, ano inyong mode or modality na gamiton sa inyong section, ang inyong isabat is blended distance learning. Hindi lang ya modular. Magambal ka, blended distance learning, dua na daya. Modular, kag online distance learning. Pero kay earlier, may mga nagambal na hindi gid sila yaka connect. Pero pila man lang sila, pero hopefully kaya pa. Anyway, maski cellphone lang, based man sa inyo na experience mo bong, kaya man mag-attend sa klase na maski cellphone lang imo nga gamiton. And again, i-record ko man ini, pwede mo na later on kung maka-access ka ng internet, tanawon mo ang ginistoryahan dito. Bilog ini, naging discuss ta, makitaan nyo na sa i-share na ako later on na recorded na itong conversation. Okay, so blended distance learning and online distance learning, that's why a modular rather, and online distance learning, that's why blended distance learning ang gamiton sa STEM. STEM 12, kag 11 STEM. The rest of the sections, modular lang yun sila. Yeah, muna nga mo, kung kaya tani na mag-online, combined with modular, mas nami, para at least may ka-klase gyapon sa inyo, unlike ang kamukamu lang nag-abinasa kung nag-in-answer. Okay. Another, kay since may online kita, may matabo kitang synchronous learning kag asynchronous learning. So anong difference ini? Magambal ka sa synchronous learning, this shall be conducted using live webinars, video conference, live chat, or instant messaging. What we're doing now is called synchronous learning. Magambal synchronous, dululuman. Through Google Meet, through Zoom, and try taman ang iban kung kaya tayo try. And in synchronous learning, teachers are highly encouraged to use Google Meet to record a specific activity, especially for performance task-based outputs. So I remember si Cliff may concern na kung pwede tani through group chat, Facebook, Messenger, ay less ang consumption sa data. Meaning kay again, mabudlayan ta mag-record sa Facebook Messenger kag ma-access later on sa mga wala naka-join sa synchronous na learning. So ang ako lang nabalaan is Zoom and Google Meet ang pwede ka-record. Pag nubo na ni siya daso ng iyang size, kung i-record na siya, so hapo siya dahil i-send na lang through Messenger, through YouTube, or i-upload sa Facebook. Lessons shall be recorded for students who miss the lessons for viewing later. Kaya muna sa akong gina-point out kagina na it need a record kaya para ang mga wala diri person ng kay Abby and kay Jeremy na wala subong, kay Blossom, para kahit hindi sila sa natabo, pwede nila matanaw later on. Pero asynchronous na na siya. Kaya hindi na siya duman sa aton. Okay? Another, in synchronous learning should be conducted within a limited period. This one, hindi nyo manigid ni siguro kamukadugay na exposure. Unlike sa college, na halos bilugid sa lang adlaw, gindya, kaya ay online, purely blended learning, I mean, ang sa college, do kabudlay man na mag-modular lang sa college. So may 2020 rule. If ever man, basi mag-exceed kita sa 1 hour, so may 2020 rule para hindi man dasig magka-problema or mag-eye strain or magka-problema sa inyong mata. So what is this 2020 rule? Meaning, after 20 minutes na nagatanaw ka mo sa tablet, sa laptop, sa computer, or sa cellphone, after 20 minutes, tanaw ka sa isa ka object na 20 feet away sa imo, this sa iyong distance sa imo. So the first 20 again means 20 minutes. Ang second 20 means 20 feet. Ang last na 20 means 20 seconds. So meaning after 20 minutes, look for an object that is 20 feet away from you and stare or look at that object for 20 seconds. So para hindi dasig maguba ang mata or hindi ma-strain ang mata. Okay, so that's the 2020 rule. Another thing, synchronous learning in each subject may be done at least once to a maximum of 3 times per week depending upon the age and grade level of the learners. Ang ideal sa grade 12 is actually twice a week. Pero later on, i-present ko sa inyo ang schedule para may idea gid ka mo kung saan ugid mo online or need pala mag-online every day. So later on sa next na slides. Live classes in each subject may be conducted during their first meeting schedule for the week to set direction, explain the details of the lesson, and give instructions about the asynchronous learning task. Okay, again, kung nag-Google Meet na o nag-Google Zoom, that's synchronous. But that doesn't mean na class, sige na siya yung recorded and ginaubra. Pwede na siya, pero hindi na siya exclusive na mo lang na. Pwede ya ang online class, ina-instruct mo lang ang students sa mga directions na gusto nga obraw ni teacher para sa ilang modules. Okay? So, amo man na siya ang ginaubra ta subong. Kaya para lang, i-discuss ko, i-orienta ka mo sa matabo sa aton through this synchronous learning. But this doesn't mean nga affected in your grades. Kaya this is not yet part of the actual school year pa yan. This is just the orientation. And live classes during the following days, if any, may be devoted to giving feedback to learners and engaging them in live collaboration work. Okay, so I'll just give an example. Hindi subong nag-virtual meeting ta. And then nag-schedule na ang eskwilahan para manghatag isang module. Tapos may schedule kamusin na para mag-ubra sang module sa amula ng subject. Since nabudlayan, let's just say, gusto nyo kaya i-explain sa inyo, i-discuss sa inyo, ma-request ka mo sang synchronous learning. So si teacher, ma-schedule na siya sining Google Meet para i-discuss ang ara sa inyong module. So muna siya ang purpose niya sa online learning. So kung tanan present, pwede ko na ka-test. Pero kung hindi, di more on discussion na siya. Or pwede makugyapon kahatag test ya, hindi ko lang pag-reveal ang answer sa Google Meet. Ang makakuha later on, pwede nga through Facebook Messenger ko lang sila i-ask some questions. Or pwede through text message ko lang sila i-ask ang questions para makakuha sila sa amo na test. Okay? And this also helps build a community in the class, engages students, and makes the learning more interactive. Again, para ma-feel nung madugo class, yun ang yapon. That's why I encourage kid ang online learning kay kung binato na dito mo sa module ka in-answer, do ma-feel ninyo nga do wala ka mo sa interaction sa inyong school. So again, mas okay niya kahit kita yung nag-choose ta sang option of online distance learning. That's why blended distance learning ang atong na ginagamit. Okay, and lastly, asynchronous learning avoids the assumption that technology is readily available for learners when the teacher deems it as necessary or that learners are in an environment that is free of distraction at the allotted class meeting time. So ang mga nagiging viral na Facebook ng mga videos, ngayon lang na-disconnect ang estudyante, nadulaan sa connection. So, wrong gid man naya ang teacher nga ginaakigan si estudyante kay na-fail niya guro nga itindihon na may asynchronous dapat na option. Kay tungod gani, gina-assume naya, expected naya nga may problema gidya sa internet connectivity sa bilog na Pilipinas, so hindi pwede nga exclusive lang for synchronous learning. Dapat ginapanundong din ni teacher nga may mga estudyante nga hindi kaya makakonect, so dapat may asynchronous gidya learning option. Okay? Learning materials may be posted online and learners may work through them in their own time. That is for SLMs. Collaborating asynchronously with other learners and with the teacher via online forum, email, and others. Another good option of synchronous learning is kamu lang yan mismo kung hindi ka mo abig kabalo mag-answer sa specific topic or a certain topic, pwede ka mo mismo makaschedule sa Google Meet or Zoom meeting and may somebody lang mabulig sa inyo explain or discuss para ma-answeran nyo ang mga ginapa-answeran ni teacher. So, not necessarily nga ara from si teacher, pwede ka mo yung kakandak sa online discussion na kamukamu lang yung estudyante. So that is still part of the online distance learning under the blended distance learning. Okay? Okay. Better now, Janus. Basi sa connection lang. Okay. Moving on now. So this time, I'm going to mention your subjects, the teachers, and the class schedule. So this is very important. So make sure na you take down notes or you take a screenshot or take a picture of the slide para guided ka mo sa class schedule. Okay, by October 5, mas start na officially ang school year 2020-2021. Okay, let's have the
next slide.
Please check. Can you see the slide now? In the slide are your subjects. Please type sa chat box kung hindi nyo makita. Ang hindi lang.
Kita, sir.
Kita, sir.
Wala na, kita.
Okay. Okay, again, I'll give you the time to take a picture of the subjects or take a screenshot para at least mabalaan nyo ang inyong mga subjects. So you have a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 subjects for first semester of school year 2020-2021. Okay, I hope nakakuha ka mo sa screenshot, picture, or makopya. Okay, I'll proceed now to the next slide. The next slide will show you the names of the teachers. Okay, for the MIL, your subject teacher is Sir Nash Rudin Rojas. And I think si Sir Nash siya makonduct din siya sa online distance learning man. Kay okay man niya yung internet connection. Also, for intro to the philo or philosophy of the human person, si Sir Nino Ryan Raimundo. For your contemporary Philippine arts from the region, si Ma'am Yu Chantal. For DRR, Ma'am Ninyo Patani. For PE, still, Ma'am Chantal. For research, yours truly, I will be your research teacher as well, aside from the other subject. For pagsulat sa Filipino sa Piling Larang, Mr. Michael Marcelino. For your general physics, si Ma'am Johanne Grace, now Mrs. Honey Grace Luna na. And ako gyapon inyong general biology 1. So I will be handling 2 subjects for the first semester for 12 STEM, research, and also general biology. Okay, so these are your subject teachers for school year 2020-2021. Okay, so if there are changes, of course, I'll update you. But I think to amumani sa last year, ang set of, except lang sa research, sa research last year, si Sir Nash yata, isang first sem. So this time, at least ako na inyo research and also general biology. Okay, now, for your schedule. Are na, amumani sa schedule. Okay, tanan ni siya ng grade 12, pero i-highlight ko lang dire ang, of course, ang 12 STEM. Okay, and for the 12 STEM, ara lang ya ang inyo na schedule. Take note, please try to look into the slide. Sa leftmost na part, diri nga part, ari diri ang days. Okay, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and may Saturday. Pero ano ang matabo dira? Okay, again, the suggestion is only 2 hours in the morning, 2 hours in the afternoon per subject. Okay, unlike ya sang dati, 1 hour per subject per period. Okay, so the whole day halos ya, or 8 subjects or 9 subjects in a day. Pero sa new setup, only 1 subject in the morning, 1 subject in the afternoon. Okay, for Monday, 9:30 to 11:30, it will be our subject, general biology. Sa hapon, is contempo, okay, for contempo under mom guardian. So, sa Monday, dua lang yung subject, isa sa aga, isa sa hapon. Okay, for Tuesday, E6 and DRR. For Wednesday, PE and health. For Thursday, morning research, afternoon, pagsulat. And for Friday, since usually actually, sa other sections, pwede nga 4 lang, 4 days lang. Pero kay, this is first sem, damo subjects, so nag-aabot pati Friday. Pero morning na lang ang Friday, that is your philo. What will happen sa Friday afternoon? A Friday afternoon, 1 to 3, diri na kamo maubra sa inyong portfolio. Kaya again, ang inyong gisinya actually ubrahon, gidya is portfolio for every subject. Okay, do dirigid ang magiging basis sa inyong grade. Anyway, si teacher man na madiscuss kung ano dira ang inyong mga ibutang sa portfolio. And on Saturday, okay, take note here, distribution of self-learning modules, submission of weekly activity sheets or worksheets and other forms pangagin na paubra ni teacher. That's every Saturday. However, hindi nila niya concern kay bawal pa magwa ang under 21. Concern ay nasang parents. Pero pwede man niya nga hindi magkanto sa eskwelahan. So may options with that. Anyway, for later on. No math anymore sa grade 12 STEM. General, ang inyo chemistry, ang inyo physics, puros man ng math. May chem 2 pag yun ka mo, pag may physics 2 pag abot naman sa second sem. Calculus actually ang inyo na physics, so it's still math. Math man lagi ako. Okay. Question so far? Okay, so example lang. Since kamuya, ang hindi iya sang blended distance learning, meaning ang purely modular, meaning the rest of the section, matabusin na sila ya, mag-Monday, 9:30 to 11:30, before that, ang module, ginhatag na sa ila before pa yan nag-October 5. Okay? And then, ma-answer sila sang module nga biology lang gid, sa oras lang gid nga muna. Meaning, ang iniya nga oras, kamo siniya ang may control. Hindi na ya si teacher, especially kung modular. Suggestion na lang niya halos nga mag-Monday, 9:30 to 11:30, dapat nag-aubra ka sang module sa general bio. Pagkahapon, maubra ka sang module sang contempo. So, amo na yung matabo. Pero, kamuya may online, amo manigya po niya ang schedule for module, pero pwede ya kaset si teacher. Example, ako, kay may Monday, tanga 9:30 to 11:30, mahambal ko yang sa Monday 9:30 to 11:30 ma-synchronous discussion kita. Okay? So ako niya oras akong nagamiton. Pero as Monday ko lang ginasaya maubra. So that's why nga not necessarily nga everyday gid ka muya mag-online or everyday ka mo nga 8 hours nga naga-video call. No. Pwede ka muya ka-discuss sa inyo teacher nga hindi ka mo magdulungan. Hindi man na maski ako man hindi mo ko everyday gid of course mag-online call sa inyo. Mga once a week lang gid man. Ito yung mag once a week every subject, tipila malang na isa sa, maski gani once every 2 weeks, pwede pa man asang teacher. Kung ano malang na for updates malang, for other means malang of discussion. Okay? So that's why ginasa-encourage ko kita ng online para lagi na nag-discuss kay hindi puro lang nakamulang nag-a-enhancer. Okay, question so far? Oh, wala man. Okay, so I'll have now the next slide. Oh, this one, this is very, very important for me and also for the subject teachers. Again, modular man ka muya gyapon, pero may online pag ito mo yung option. So blended distance learning. Kamulang gid ang pinasahi na section together with 11 STEM na may online option sa inyong modality. Pero ang inyong modular, pwede yung digital or pwede hard copy. This one. Kaya please make sure nga nakafocus gid. Ang importante ni later on ang inyong answer sa amo ning question. Pero i-explain ko danay ang advantages and disadvantages. Anong ginamin sinisang digital or hard copy? Ang module or self-learning material. Pwede man ang LAS or learning activity sheets or ang mga activity sheets. Or ang ibang pagid nga obraho ni teacher. Pwede digital or soft copy, pwede hard copy. Isa-isa hunta ang advantages and disadvantages. For digital, syempre kung digital, no need to go to school. Your parents. Muni siya gani, ang gina-encourage, kagina lang nagbasa ko sa ABS-CBN News, na gina-encourage, gina digital, ang purpose is para hindi man na-expose inyo parents sa outside. Kaya kailangan, gina, kung hard copy later on, kailangan, gina, of course, kwaon si iskilaan sa inyong mga parents. Kung digital yan, okay, anyway, gabasa gani, Wattpad, nag-iba siguro, or kaya man mag-open PDF sa inyong mga cellphone, kung kaya mo lang, kung may laptop better, kung may desktop better, okay? Digital copy na lang ang ihatag ni teacher ng module sa learning activity. Okay? So inyo na nasaya dahil yung copy. Pwede nyo i-print, pwede man hindi. Pero hindi na kailangan pag ibalik kay teacher kung digital ang inyong ginpangayo. Another, again, it will be sent using PDF format or document. Pwede sa Messenger, pwede sa email, or pwede sa Google Drive, depende sa ato na agreement. Siguro more on maubra kita sa separate gid nga Messenger nga ang ara lang gid nadaya puros PDF kag documents sa group chat. Kay ini aton group chat nga existing subong dira lang yang mga announcement. Kasi sometimes sabi kung may naga-announce dira natatabunan na ang mga documents nga gi-send or iban pa. So mga ubra lang ta siguro separate nga page, pwede man niya Google Drive kung familiar ka mo ma-open man lang kamo sina ara na dali tanan na subjects. And kung ara na may digital copy na kamo, ang inyo na sinobrahon is mabasa kamo. May part na da, mga isa man lang na da, dua or tatlo ka pages nga may mga questions. Tapos mag-answer kamo, tidira lang kamo pangita sa papel or bond paper, tidira kamo answer. Since digital lang inyong copy, hindi nyo na kailangan niyang dalon na inyong answer sheet sa eskwilahan, I mean dalon sa parents nyo sa eskwilahan, but you can just take a picture of your answer pag isend sa subject teacher na concern sa amo ng subject. Or, kung nag-type ka mo sa Word, pwede nyo isend ang inyong soft copy sa answer na lang yan. Answer na lang gid. Kung may multiple choice na 10 items, di ang answer mo lang sa number 1 to 10, yung imo ipasa. Okay? Pero kung module yan, na hard copy, ara na, amon niya siya ang mga options. Kung hard copy, ang inyong mga pangayoon, so parents gid ya, magkadto sa school almost every week. Makadto siya, magkuha sa module, makadto sa magpasa sa module, magpasa sa activity sheets, at kung ano pa da ang gina-require ni teacher. May schedule ina. Later on, i-discuss ko ang schedule kung hindi kaya sa digital. Another, may module ka na nga na button, hard copy, you are not allowed, Gidya, to write anything on the module. Kailangan mo din mangita sa separate answer sheet and masubmit dayon against si parents sa school. Okay, so that's for the hard copy. And again, must return the SLMs and the learn or self-learning materials and the learning activity sheets to the school through the hard copy. Kung hard copy ang imo pang ngayon. Again, ang kada estudyante may option na magpili kung soft copy or hard copy ang iyang module or activity. So that's why nga this is a very important meeting kay kailangan ko din mabalaan kung sino exactly ang hard copy lang or soft copy pag para sila lang niya ang among printan. Kaya again, sa tuod lang, halos maguba ng printer ko in just 1 week pa lang ang module sa gina-prepare ko. Mga 80% pa lang ako na print. Though, masuko na ang printer. Hay, every week na daan pila 20 plus ka pages ang kailangan i-print per student. So, mas gina-encourage gitani. Pero again, hindi pilitay. Kung hindi kaya, hindi ka mag-pretend na okay lang sa soft copy. Kung hindi kaya, di hard copy ka kaya. Anyway, ma-print kuya gyapon kung hard copy. Pero amo lang, kailangan magkato sa imo parents is pilahan. Anong duman nyo lang, kung over 60 years old inyo parents, pag knowing na may mga local transmission na sa Panitan, galapit mga galapit sa lutod-lutod sa Marita, may ari man di. Pontevedra, I have heard, in-stop ang sa Pontevedra National High School, na, din, na distribution of module, kay may isa dito nga nagkuha, nga na-expose sa positive sa Panitan. So, amo ang mga kailangan niyo consider. Pero again, wala pilitay, kung ano lang yung makaya ni mo, ti amo ginaya dapat sa imo. Okay? For those later on na mag-decide sa hard copy, na-post naman ni sa official na Facebook page sa Jose Diva, sa Friday, this Friday na, October 2, that's why yung nag-meeting ko before, sa amo nga date, ang grade 12, pati ang grade 11, makadto ang parents or guardians is pilahan, alauna, hasta alas 3. Ako, ara man na dala, if ever, ara ang parents. Okay, so, amo pag ini, damo, makadto sa ispilahan, so medyo kululbaan, gani. Kung ma-hard copy ka mo, kay hindi ka mo yan pwede, bawal ka dyan estudyante, only 21 above and not over 60 years old. Amo lang gina ang allowed na magkuha sang module. Okay, I hope naklaro gina ang difference ang soft copy kag hard copy kag in-explain sang maayo kay para maka-decide na kamo. So this is one of the important information na I'll be needing from you. This is now your time to decide whether you are going to have all tanan na subjects. Not only in my subject, but this is for all subjects para ma-inform ko ang teachers kung pila lang yung i-print sa akong section sa amunang subject. Okay, kung soft copy, imobra ito sa mga separate lang yun na Facebook page, kagdira lang yung i-send through PDF. Kung naka-open ka PDF, okay, nung gabasa ka malang nadali, answer ka na malang dayon sa sheet of paper, eh, makasave ka na sa papel, hindi pa marisguhan ang imuna parents of going to the school. Okay, but again, you have the freedom to decide. Wala ko ga-impose. Pinapaklaro ko lang sa inyo inyong options. And this time, wala pa naka-present sa next slide. Pero the next slide actually, naka-blank dara, inyo names. Same thing as I call your name, you have to choose between print and digital. Okay, again na, basi kay tungod majority, amuna, masunod ka naman lang. No, know your situation. Know your capabilities, kung ano lang yan yung masarangan, kung hindi ka gidya capable of digital copy, then don't force yourself. Okay, I hope I am clear on that. Now, I'll call you one by one, and please, as I call your name, turn on again your audio, unmute your audio, and answer whether you are going to choose print or digital copy. So si Abby wala, so i-text ko na lang siya or i-chat later on kung ano yung option. Next.
Sir, excuse.
Yes. Sino ni? Please, sir.
Pwede ka next, sir.
Joseph, yes, Joseph.
What if, Abby, sir, kung hindi ang mother, pwede ang magulang above 21 years old?
Yes, any member of the family, basta, pwede gani kung papagbalay, kung same lang man household. Ang iba na muna ginagbalay, padala-padala lang. Pwede good, kaya again, gina-avoid gani mag magluluto to kay bawal gidya ang crowd, bawal gidya ang overcrowding sa isang lugar. Pwede gid, hindi siya exclusive na parent lang, basta sobra sa 21 years old, hindi lang maglato sa 60 years old. Hindi kailangan na blood related, basta kakilala mo ay hatag sa imong module. Pag siya man ang mapasa sa module pabalik sa eskwela, pwede gid. Okay, Joseph?
Okay, sir. Oh,
okay. So again, David, duara ka naman na kanina. Kari ko sa. David, para ma-present pa pag today.
Sir.
Okay, arin na, malinakaw ka na. Please, choose. Again na, ano mo module. Anyway, may ara na ako actually ano mag identify last time. Gusto ko i-finalize kung amo man inigyapon sila or madugangan or may iba na. David.
Sir.
Print or digital?
Why po kabalo, sir? Kaya ano, sir? Kaya manang kung ano bala decision, sir? Kaya siya lang naman, ano, kung manos kami, sir?
Hindi, wala ko naintindihan, what? Kay ma'am mo, Elden?
Oh, sir.
So, meaning, ma-print na lang para siya makuha.
Amo, yes, sir, ko ba mag-quote, sir, kung ano bala, sir? Kaya duwa kami dan, dance system, sir, mo? Kaya para do, ano bala, sir, para pariyo na lang, ano na lang, nang dungan, bala? Or ano?
Ikaw yan, mas ikaw, ano?
Okay, okay, sir. Ay, simpre, sir. Si mama, ay, ano, 60. Nasa sir mo, bawal, di ba? 60 below.
Kaya haraman sa mga. Pero kung gusto mo balaan, kung ano mas gusto ni mo, ang printed na kopya, or kaya mo man magbasa lang sa cellphone or sa laptop?
Mas print, ano naman, print lang, guro, sir.
Okay, so printed for David. Anyway, okay. Abang mo, araman niya sa mga Elden, kakatsos
ko lang, sir.
Okay, thank you,
sir.
David.
Sir.
Next, okay, unmute na lang imo audio. Jumel? Jumel? Ara mo si Jumel? Unmute imo audio. Okay, balikila ko Jumel kung okay ka na da. John Russell?
Sir.
Yes, print or digital?
Digital, sir.
Okay, noted. Thank you. Narvin? Narvin, still there? Kung hindi ka audio, ano lang, i-chat lang inyong response. Moment kay Jumel, wala pa ko ka ano sa iyang option. Let's proceed. Narvin and Jumela, just chat lang your response kung okay na kami. Si Cyril is not here. Donnie?
Digital, sir.
Digital kay Narvin. Donnie, digital. Okay, noted. Joshua?
Digital ko, sir.
Okay, noted. Facilito. Digital. Thank you. Joseph? Modular ka, guro?
Printed.
Okay. Bon?
Digital ko, sir, para hindi na si mama maglakat-lakat, sir.
Okay, good. Si Edmar, kare din? Wala na. Why si Edmar? Christian, pasigna. Aris, ha? Pasigna. Okay, sa chat lang, galing ni Feber. Janus?
Digital, sir. Digital.
Okay, sige. Janus speaking. Please again, furnish me a copy of your soft copy ng card. Kaya ka pa officially na enroll.
Yes, sir.
Picture lang. Thank you. Next. Cliff. Jumel, digital. Jumel, button digital. Cliff again, digital. Chat na lang, Cliff. Angel?
Digital, sir.
Okay, copy. Blossom? Okay na, Cliff. Digital. Ari si Blossom, why not? Okay, next. Mika? Digital. Shami? Okay, copy. Ayla? Copy. Rizal?
Digital, sir.
Okay, noted. Carissa? Okay, noted. Jemima? printed. Okay, noted. Justin? Okay, noted. Christine May?
Digital, sir.
Okay, thank you. Noted. Sheila? Okay, digital. Noted. Genevieve?
Digital, sir.
Genevieve, middle initial mo ka ni Genevieve, D, no? Delta?
Ano, sir?
Imo middle initial?
Gonzales, sir?
Letter G? Gonzales?
Oo, oo.
Okay. Okay, wala ko din na butangan. Thank you, thank you. Julian? Okay, noted, Julian. Justin? Actually, Justin? Romualdo? Arikad? Answer na. Bebe Rose?
Digital, sir.
Okay, thank you, Bebe Rose. Jeremy is not here. Okay, so Justin lang, please confirm. Kay ikaw na lang di so far ang wait ko nabutangan sa mga present. Okay, okay, Justin, thank you.
Digital, sir, sir.
Okay na, Justin. Okay, just to confirm again your answers para lang klaro tatanan. Si Abby, wala pa, message lang. Si David printed, Jomel digital, John Russell digital, Narvin digital. Si Cyril, I think nag-printed po siya. Donnie Digital, Joshua Digital, Facilito Digital, Joseph printed, Von Brian Digital, si Edmar, kag si Christian, i-message ko lang. Janus Digital, Cliff Digital, Angel Digital, Mia Digital, among the girls, si Jemima lang ang print, and no answer from Blossom and Jeremy. I'll just wait for their response lang. But so far, majority digital. So good thing, at least, hindi na kailangan na ma-expose yung parents sa eskwelahan kaya madugso hindi ang parents for those hindi. But again, ang makuha printed, again, kung pwede sa inyo barangay or lugar pala na para hapos, yung kinaka-oras ang grade 12 at ang grade 11 para hindi magdamo ang madugso dito ang mga parents. Okay, thank you again for your responses. Okay, we are now almost ending this digital virtual meeting. If you have questions, David, sir, paano kung digital, abi sir, pwede pa? Pwede gid, abi, example, experience nyo in the middle of the week, patapuson lang siguro ang isa ka semana. Let's just say, kung send man ko mo group chat, accessible nyo man na sa page na hindi ko na sa isa-isa pag i-send sa inyo. I-access nyo yan mismo. Let's say, abin nakabutang dala. Bio 1, week 1. Amo na inyo i-open. So kung ma-open mo man niya, David, hindi mo na kailangan pagkuhaon ng modules sa eskwelahan. Okay? So amo na siyang option. Amo na siyang magiging option. Pero, kung hindi nyo kaya mag-digital, just inform me a week before. May baka ba next week, sir, do gusto ko na lang mag-printed. Inform me hindi dapat may oras na. Kaya again, hindi lang na ako ang ma-print. Ang walo nyo pag-git ka subject teachers, 7, kay duwa akong subjects, kailangan mag-prepare man before matagaan ka mo sa hard copy. Okay? Amo pag na para tipid, hindi mag-plite ang inyo principal today. Ang inyong naila i-plite, igasto na lang nila sa load para at least kung mag-online class, maka-access ka mo. Safe pa, correct. Tama, git. Okay, oh, again, any more concerns? Okay, it's already 2:45. Kung may concerns pa, this is not the time to have the open forum. Okay? So, kung wala na, the next slide here is actually for tutorial again. Kaya nag-majority na ang present. So, i-end na na. May next na. Yes? Yes, Joshua?
Confirm kami. May uniform pa, sir? Hindi na.
Kamo, amo man na, aga na sa ato niya section, you have all the freedom, hindi ko gusto mag-impose. kung gusto niyo nga abi try naman na mag-uniform kay para doon na kayo pagiging estudyante, pwede gid, wala gid na yan magiging problema at all. Kung trip ninyo. Pero kung hindi niyo trip, eh, hindi man.
Sige, sir.
Hindi siya required. Hindi siya required. Pero kung gusto niyo again, you have the option. Pwede ka mo yung ka-decide as a section. Or again, kung gusto mo yung mag-uniform while online class, kay ulirang mag-aaral ka, eh, huwag na yung problema at all. Sino pa kung may pamangkot, i-turn on nyo lang inyong mic.
Ako, sir. Joseph.
Yes, Joseph. Yes.
Para bi sir kon akon di ba gin pili modular lang. Tapos akon pilion.
Yes.
For example, digital. Pwede lang na sa nga hindi na ako mag-attend sa online class.
Okay. Ang again, kailangan ato na biya, kailangan yung gid makakuha sang self-learning material. Tanan yung estudyante dapat makabaton sa self-learning material. Either hard copy or soft copy. Okay. Pero kaya ang ato niya nga section, majority nagpili sang online distance learning, na part sang blended learning. Ang online class ya, hindi na siya necessarily ngayon nag-klase si nag-klase nga mahatag sang test. Hindi siya exclusive na mo lang na. Pero pwede na any teacher mo obra. O ako pwede ko na maubra, pero sabi subong, do majority, do ari lang taganit halos sa classroom, kay do halos 90% man ang present. Pwede ko yung katag test, galing hindi ko lang pag i-reveal ang answer, kay tungod nga na recorded ini ang ato naging klase. So ang mga wala na contact, pwede na sila nakonkontak through text lang or through chat, pagdara ko din yung hatag ang test sa ila para tanan makakuha sa test. Including you, Joseph. Anyway, may cellphone ka man, pwede ka gyapon makabaton sang text nga may quiz nga muna or may ara ka kwaon activity para ma-record ikaw. Pero hindi siya again exclusive lang for online class. Pwede mo yan tanawon ng online class later on kay wala ka ka-join para kaintindi ka kung ano ang gin-explain ni teacher during the time. Kay recorded man ini siyang discussion. Gets mo, Joseph?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Sino pa may concern? Tapos na time kay para at least klaro tatanan mag-start sang klase. Si Cyril, tani damo siya pamangkot galing kay unfortunately hindi man siya ka-join. Sino ara sa school? Sino na video? Mo kita. Si David ara sa kanila sa school. Okay. Questions pa so far? Okay na. O kung wala, let's have a tutorial kay para may upload ko sa Facebook. So everyone. I must stop presenting ko naman. Sixta. Okay. Very good. Kaya halos nakauntan na ang video. Pero akong video naka-off nila. Okay. Look at the camera and after three counts, I will take a screenshot of this Google Meet para may picture kita tanan. Okay, show your best smile in 3, 2, 1. Tapa, ma-picture pa dito para damo ko kopya. Okay, again, everyone, show your best smile in 3, 2, 1. Okay. May last slide lang kung may pakita. kaya rin yung mga itsura. Kung gusto nyo makita inyong mga itsura. Mo na inyo yung itsura na i-upload ko sa ato na Facebook page pag ma-show sa recording. Okay, ano lang. Last slide na lang. This is just to somehow encourage you or enlighten you. Okay? It's just a reminder. Okay, so since this is really a challenging time to all of us, we did not expect this at all. This really is a great challenge to everyone. But please remember that we don't grow when things are easy. We grow when we face challenges. So take this challenge as our way to grow. And who knows, at least diba, because of this new normal, you're able to experience the online type of learning. Okay, so on that note, I am ending now my presentation. And again, are there questions? Pwede nyo naman on inyong camera kung magsiningitan. Ay, kamo kay tapos naman ta, call.
Hello, everyone.
Hey.
Hello.
Pwede na kamo na. Sir, kapinawa sila epic, sir.
Hey. Hello.
Mga epic.
Sir, kapinawa sila epic, sir.
Gahod.
May problema, basta may nakawalas. Okay lang.
Okay.
Ngong.
Kaya ang online class? Kaya?
Kaya, sir. Kaya.
Okay. Okay.
Carry lang.
Pang data.
Para sa grade. Joke lang.
Para doon, ma-feel mo na sa dyan.
No.
By the way, Janus, is your new classmate.
Hello.
Ito na lang introduction.
Bebeb.
Makabalos. Good gila sa kapinang uwa. Sa ano? Sa epic. Miss you, Beb!
Ako, miss you.
I will just send recorded na conversation, recorded ka Google Meet sa group chat. Okay.
Kung
may concerns pa, just text me or chat lang sa messenger. Gahod ang audio.
Hi, Len.
I think we can end this call. Thank you, everyone. Stay safe.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
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 Sana all.
Robin.
Good job.
Tunggu.
Tunggu. Tunggu. Tunggu.